In Sanadu did Kobla Khan a stately pleasure done decree, whereof the sacred river ran through caverns missionless to man unto a sunless sea. So twice 5 miles of fertile ground with walls and towers were girdled round, and there were gardens bright with sinuous rose, where blossomed many an incense-bearing tree, and here were forests and seen as the hills enfolding sunny spots of greenery. But all that deep romantic chasm which slanted down the grain hill athwart a cedarn cover, a savage place, as holy and enchanted as the air beneath a waning moon was haunted by a woman wailing for her demon lover. And from this chasm, with ceaseless turmoil seething, as if this earth in fast thick pants were breathing, a mighty fountain momently was forced, amid whose swift half-intermitted burst huge fragments vaulted like rebounding hail, or chaffy grain beneath the thresher's flail. And mid these dancing rocks at once and ever, it flung up momently the sacred river, 5 miles mending with a mazy motion through wood and dell the sacred river ran, then reached the caverns measureless to man, and sank in tumult to a lifeless ocean. And amid this tumult Kubla heard from far ancestral voices prophesying war. The shadow of the dawn of pleasure floated midway on the waves, where was heard the mingled measure from the fountain and the caves. It was a miracle of rare device, a sunny pleasure dumb with caves of ice. A damsel with a dulcimer, in a vision once I saw. It was an Abyssinian maid, and on her dulcimer she played, singing of Mount Abora. Could I revive within me her symphony and song to such a deep delight, 'twould win me, that with music loud and long I would build the dawning in air, that sunny dome those caves of ice, and all the world should see them there, and all should cry, beware, beware, his flashing eyes, his floating hair. Weave a circle round him thrice, and close your eyes with holy dread, for he on honey dew hath fed, and drunk the milk of paradise.